actually explaining together how TU Delft and KLM work together to change the passenger experience by co-creating and experimenting during real-life operations.
And what does that mean?
Well, that actually means that it's almost as simple as I just said it. What we provide is an environment for our customers and our employees to test out new ways of working and new products in live operations. So not in a lab, not in our headquarters, but during real operations. We just try out new things and we get direct customer feedback, that direct employee feedback. And based on that, we change how KLM operates.
And Christine, this seems an obvious way to do it, but perhaps it is new to the industry to actually get that sort of real direct feedback.
Well, as an industry, we're very used to promising the world to the passenger. If you look at all the advertising that we do from airlines and airports towards the passengers, we promise them an adventure and magic happening all the way through this journey. But we're actually trying to make it actually happen. So how can we make sure that we don't only make the promises, but actually deliver those promises? And what you hear in all the presentations is that everybody's very keen on trying to do so, but we don't have the answer yet. So that's why we are, as a university, trying to partner up and really becoming a knowledge part and develop that knowledge together.
And interesting you said about that experience thing, first of all, that kind of sort of adventure. Mm-hmm. Is there an element that maybe 30 years ago for a lot of travelers that was true because it was an adventure, but we're all used to flying a little bit more now, so that we need a little bit more than just the fact we're doing it?
Well, the funny thing is that many people tell us it almost feels like taking the train off the bus because we're so used to it, we know what to expect, but somehow somewhere people still feel that thrill of I'm actually flying to a different country here, I'm actually flying over this vast amount of territory and I don't know what it's about. It's the unknown that still triggers us. And we really want to bring that bit of magic and adventure and being conscious about the step you're making while flying back to the passengers.
And I guess the point is, doing it this way, you find out some interesting answers.
Well, yeah, so first of all, the last speaker we saw, he talked about being humble. And I think that's quite important, that you understand that the change, the difference between promising and delivering, it's actually a big one. So by co-creating with your passengers and your employees and being humble about that, don't making a marketing story out of it, but really change tangible things, which really makes a difference. That is a difference in itself. I mean, it sounds so simple, but what I see in this conference, we all have similar stories from the airline industry. We all want to put our customer center stage, and we really want that. We all want to have our customers to have a better experience than our competitors. But the fact is, it's very easy to say, and it's very difficult to do it, and it's very difficult to do it every day. So by co-creating in real operational environments, we figured out that if it works in a snowstorm, it also works during the summer, right? And it doesn't work if you think it up in headquarters. It only works in your PowerPoint presentation or in your spreadsheet. And I think that's a really game changer to do it like that, to approach it like that.
And passengers are not just used as a source of data, because we have a lot of data on our passengers, but we actually give our passengers an active voice in what to create for them and really make them owner in what's coming next in their journey. And they're in charge of determining what they want to achieve and what they want to experience.
And I guess the mistake often in all sorts of industries is if you're a provider of something, you may think you know what people want, but often you just get a little bit removed from that. So it's a good way to really get in touch and get a reminder of what people do want.
Yeah, it is. It's all about that, yeah.
And what's the reaction here today from what your presentation? What did people say?
Well, there were a lot of people nodding when we said the actual difficulty is to acknowledge that we're not very good at delivering the promise, and that it's really difficult. There was a guy who said people's hair are on fire. Everybody's people, the hair of everyone is on fire all the time in the airline industry. We're running around chasing fires, but it's very difficult to just listen to a passenger and really make contact and really hear what people want and change your way of working. There was a lot of nodding, there were a lot of picture taking, and what I noticed is that's, I think, the most important sign that people are listening and thinking it's very, very interesting. People recognized it, recognized the challenges,
We hear a lot of people like, it's already so hard in running our day-to-day business, and we're trying to push that even forward. Okay, let's take that for granted, but really try to question things as they are, so that we can really push forward to what can happen in 5 to 10 years' time.
It makes it easier all round, I guess, if you actually do that, and so some of your day-to-day challenges may become a little bit easier. Tell me, why is it good to come to this event and this conference? What do you think of being here and sharing your ideas here?
Well, the most interesting part is to see how people are pursuing their customer-centric strategy. So what I already said, there are a lot of similar stories, and we have a lot of we share similar strategies, but we all pursue them in a different way. And what I really like is to get in the head of all the other people in the industry and see their examples and their approach and try to learn from them and take out the best practices and try them myself.
And Christine, you know from sort of academia that it's important to get together and chat different ideas. What do you think of the event?
Well, we're a regular here. We come here already for quite some years, and we love how to we don't want to position ourselves as an ivory tower. We really want to be involved in the mud and really tackle the challenges together. And we see that there's the most knowledge to gain. And we learn from what's going on here at this conference that we better are capable of defining our own research agenda. What should we focus on in the coming years?